以下节目是由史丹佛医学院特约播映。欢迎回来商界纵横，在这一节的商界纵横呢，我们将为大家介绍由史丹佛医学院所举办的健康疗法，糖尿病的健康疗法调研。而这个调研是什么东西呢？我们一会儿会为大家详细的解释。因为根据2015年的一项调查结果显示，全球目前呢有差不多4亿1000万人罹患这个糖尿病，而在光是在中国呢，这个数据已经是高达1.5亿人，所以这个数据是非常的高。而今天呢，我们很荣幸的邀请到史丹佛大学的副总监 Dr. Farooqi 来到节目当中，来为大家讲解什么是糖尿病，然后他们这个调研到底什么人符合资格参加呢？ Hi Dr. Farooqi, welcome to Business and Lifestyle.
Thank you for having me.
First I would like to know, what is this study about?
So the study is called Strong D, and it'stargeted toward normal weight diabetics, which are generally Asian. So what we're trying to figure out is why Asians who are normal weight are becoming diabetic. And we want to try to put them in an exercise program to see how we can help them.
那这个Dr. Farooqi 呢，刚刚就解释，就是说他们史丹佛大学这个健康疗法呢，就是针对呢主要像亚裔的群体呢，就很多人罹患糖尿病，但是他们并不是体重过重，而是他们本来的体重呢就是很正常，但是还是罹患这个糖尿病，所以他们想通过运动来看一下为什么亚裔呢，就是说能否就是利用这个运动呢来减低他们罹患这个糖尿病的几率。
Why is you have to focus on the normal weight diabetics in Asian community?
Well, 60% of diabetics worldwide are Asian. So that's 1 out of 2 people are Asian or are diabetic that are Asian. And it's an important issue that we need to look at. And a lot of the symptomology, they get sicker later on in life. So they think, oh, I'm skinny. I don't have any problems. I'm going to be healthy. And they don't worry about it. So we need to focus in on it, because later on in life, they get a lot of the other problems.
Thank you. Let me translate that. So 刚刚 Dr. Farooqi 呢就说呢，就是因为亚裔呢，就说因为很多呢就是罹患糖尿病，但是他的体重其实很正常，所以很多人呢并不知道自己其实有罹患这个糖尿病。而且糖尿病最大的问题呢，就是说当您年纪越大的时候呢，这个糖尿病的病症呢会越来越严重。所以呢就是亚裔这个调研呢就变成非常的重要。So I know the study is focused on the Bay Area. Why choose Bay Area then?
Bay Area is the third largest Asian population in the country. So I think there's not really a better place than this to focus in on our community.
那在湾区呢，就是因为呢，就是为什么会选湾区呢？就是因为湾区呢是全球亚裔这个市场来说，就是全美国来说呢是第三大亚裔的城市。所以呢，因为有很多亚裔住在这边，所以呢他们就选这边呢来做这个调研。So how many people you're looking for?
We're looking for 350 people, and you mentioned the Bay Area. We're also working with 24-hour fitness in 6 different locations, from San Jose to all the way to Oakland. So they can go to any 24-hour fitness. We teach them how to work out for 9 months and try to see how that helps with their diabetes.
So 9 months the study.
Months,、yeah.
那这个他们呢就是在湾区呢，他们有跟那个 24 hours fitness 呢有合作，就是这个健身中心，因为他们是24小时运作的，所以如果有参加这个调研的人士呢，就是可以在9个月之内呢就是去做运动，然后他们会根据这个运动呢来得出这个调研的结果。他们所需要呢就是现在需要这个350人。So talking about that 350 people, do they have to be able to read and speak English?
They do have to be able to read it, because they sign a consent. And then also we have to explain to them the machines, and we want to make sure they don't hurt themselves when they go to the gym. So we have to be able to speak to them in English to do that.
Yeah, so they have to understand.
They have to understand.
所以这350人呢，就是如果大家有兴趣要参加这个调研的话呢，就起码呢，就是要有这个基本英语的尝试，就是起码能跟他们会话怎么样。So talking about the study, who will qualify?
Anybody that's BMI under 25, so normal weight, and they cannot be on insulin. So they'll be taking metformin, or they're trying to control it themselves through diet and exercise, but as long as they're diabetic. Mm-hmm. They can be in the study.
So they could be either type 1 or type 2. So they
type 2.
所以如何符合条件参加的人士呢必须呢就是要就是二型的那个糖尿病然后呢就是他们这个 BMI 就是那个身高和那个体重的等值呢要在25以下如果他们就算现在有这个打这个胰岛素还是可以参加的但是呢就是 I think the another qualification is you have to be the normal diet, you know, the normal size, weight. So you can't be overweight.
You have to be normal weight. Yes. Uh-huh. We do have other studies for overweight, but this is for normal weight. And you mentioned type 1, that's something you're born with. But with this, we actually have patients that went through that brought their A1C down. And if you bring it down low enough, you get rid of the diabetes. So mm-hmm. that's what we want to do. We want to show people that they can actually, we can actually help them not be diabetic.
所以他们这个调研的主要的原因呢就是希望大家呢就是通过这个运动看出来就是说就算你体重没有超过不是吃肥的那种但是呢因为运动呢其实可以令这个就是这个肌肉呢更加的强壮其实呢就是说他们想看一下能否就是帮助这个糖尿病患从运动呢来减低这个糖尿病这个问题So talking about the study, you know, mm-hmm. a lot of times the study, they might have compensation. What about this one?
Because it's a NIH funded, the government's funding this study, we do give them a Fitbit, which this is the model that we give, and it actually tracks their exercise for them. It tells them how many steps they took, it tells them, controls their sleep. So this is the compensation that we give.
Okay, the Fitbit.
Uh-huh. And also in the beginning of the study and toward the end, we do the stress test. We do echoes to make sure their heart is well. We do physicals. So all that is covered by the study.
Mm-hmm.那刚刚那个 Dr. Farouki 呢就说呢就说这个参加这个调研的人士呢可以得到一个手表这个手表呢其实它的功能呢就是跟那个苹果的手表的其实非常的相像但是它这个手表的好处呢就除了它有时间啊大家可以收短讯啊可以有人打电话给你它也会响啊怎么样之外呢其实它最好的地方呢就是可以就是可以查到你本身这个就是你比如说每天我去那个 24-hour fitness 去做运动的时候这个所有的你的心跳率啊你做了多少运动啊它这些数据呢就自动会存到那个手表里面 So other than the Fitbit I heard you were telling me other than the you know like they would all the data would directly transfer to the study center the Fitbit can also track like how well you sleep every night it has a lot of other functions.
It has a lot of other functions, and they're actually, I think I told you this earlier, they're actually starting January, they're going to be able to test their sugar so they don't have to prick their finger. So we're going to be have that available for them.In January, but for now, it does everything else. Mm-hmm.
So before the end of the show, would you tell us the phone number?
Sure. Mm-hmm. For the study, we're actually doing emails with diabeticstudy@stanford.edu.
Mm-hmm. So whoever wants to join this program, they can just go to diabeticstudy@stanford.edu,
yeah,
right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
那刚刚呢，就像 Dr. Farouki 所说的，如果大家有兴趣参加这个调研，因为他们需要350人，而且呢就需要亚裔，而且是要体重偏瘦的 BMI 等值25以下的人士呢，不妨考虑一下可以参加，因为您可以得到一个免费的手表，然后这个手表的功能呢，就是跟苹果手表呢就是非常。相像但是它呢就是更加呢就是注重这个健康方面的那大家呢就可以上这个diabeticstudy@stanford.edu 来参加那我们今天节目时间到了感谢大家的收看我们下一次再见拜拜